Hypersonics can potentially provide Australia with an advanced long-range strike capability, moving faster than the speed of sound by a factor of five. What hypersonic really gives us is a shorter time to target, but it's actually the maneuverability and the unpredictability of the trajectory that really gives it its military advantage. With hypersonics, it's really hard to defend against. It gives us the potential for deterrence value because it allows our Australian Defence Force to hold an adversary further from our shores. Historically, Australia has had quite a deep and strong pedigree in hypersonic flight sciences, which stems from the 1960s and 70s with some world-leading early research on high-speed aerodynamics and propulsion systems. DSTG has been interested in the technology since the turn of the century, and since that time we have been investing with partners across the full range of technologies, from fundamental research across to the design and development of hypersonic systems. The focus now is helping grow a sovereign capability in test and evaluation, but also the potential for production in the future. We're really interested in working with industry and academia, with universities. Our key interest is investing in the fundamental research which will underpin the next generation technologies. There is still a lot of work to do in areas such as aerodynamics, fluid dynamics and thermal dynamics, but also scramjets and novel propulsion systems. Also very interested in high speed avionics and actuator systems, advanced materials, as well as low cost structures. And then a whole raft of work looking at experimentation techniques, modelling and simulation. With industry, we're predominantly interested in partnering in terms of the design and development of hypersonic systems. So we're talking about seekers, guidance, navigation, control, also scramjets and solar rocket motors, actuators, and of course high temperature materials and temperature protection systems. Being able to partner allows us to really scale up that effort. Co-investment is really important from a sovereign perspective as well. ADSTAR is a really important event. It's a chance to bring together defence, our international partners, also industry and academia, so that we can actually engage in that conversation, talking about what is our collective contribution to securing Australia as well as our region. The National Defence Strategy tells us that we need to partner a bit differently going into the future, a lot more open and transparent. And my hope is that ADSTAR can be a catalyst for us to break down barriers and really partner in a much more different and effective way.